This is the Daily Pulse from Speak My Word Ministries. I'm Travis Zimmerman. The episode today is entitled, Who is the Greatest? And this is a challenging topic. I mean, the passage I'm going to share is 2,000 years old, but it's so relevant even today. And it's kind of an awkward moment, you know. What we're going to see here, just to kind of set the context, is Jesus' disciples are walking with him. You know, three and a half years. They're literally sitting at his feet, listening to his teaching, sitting under his teaching, walking with him, watching the way that he instructs, and watching the way he loves God the Father, and just watching every move. You know, very public life. Now, we know Jesus had a private life in prayer as well. But here, we can kind of see the human element of things, the selfish aspect of it. And that's where it makes us go, oh, it kind of makes us wince. So this is Mark chapter 9, verses 33 to 37. And it is a little uncomfortable, but there's a lesson here, many lessons actually. This is Mark chapter 9, verses 33 to 37. Who is the greatest? They came to Capernaum. When Jesus was in the house, he asked them, "What were you arguing about on the road?" Now, we already know Jesus knows the answer to this question. He's like a parent. You know, he's not going to ask a question that he doesn't already know the answer to. "What were you arguing about on the road?" But they kept quiet because on the way they had argued about who was the greatest. Sitting down, Jesus called the 12 and said, "If anyone wants to be first, he must be the very last and the servant of all." He took a little child and had him stand among them. Taking him in his arms, he said to them, "Whoever welcomes one of these little children in my name welcomes me. And whoever welcomes me does not welcome me, but the one who sent me." Mark chapter 9, verses 33 to 37. Who is the greatest? So ostensibly, you know, Jesus catches them. You know, he already knew the thoughts of their heart. He already knows the thoughts of our hearts. But they were arguing, so they, you know, they betrayed themselves. And again, in that, we kind of pause because we're like, wow, what am I asking that's very similar to that? What am I saying in my own life that's very similar to that? Where, you know, I want to be the greatest, you know, I'm first. And Jesus has been teaching them just the opposite. Matthew 20, verse 16 said, "The first will be last and the last will be first." You know, for us Zimmermans, we love that passage, you know, sitting alphabetical order in high school. We were always last, and what it was like when the teacher said, "We're going to go reverse alphabetical order today," and we were first, and there was a cycle ahead of me, so I was never really first. But more to the point, you know, we want to be first, and what Jesus is saying, put yourself last. That's where Jesus is. The greatest really is the last. Jesus already beat us to the back of the line. He is first. And as his followers, children of God, we've got to recognize that that position of servitude, that position of humility, that position of deference is really what makes Jesus proud. It's not that, you know, our needs aren't going to be cared for, and many of our wants, they are. We know this. But what Jesus is teaching his disciples, he's also teaching us that really to be great is to be last and to serve and to not have a self-serving attitude, but, you know, others-serving attitude where we put Jesus first and others next and ourselves back of the line. In Jesus' name, amen.